Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. So far, we've learnt the difference between the three conditions of man and how they develop from one another. As usual, the previous video, as well as the book under study, the philosophy of the teachings of Islam, is in the description below. In this video, we'll be looking at further examples regarding how the natural condition transforms into the moral condition and then into the spiritual conditions. So let's get started. In the previous verse, we learnt that natural conditions are not entirely distinct from moral conditions. They acquire a moral character when they are regulated by reason at the proper place and time. His Holiness further explains that before this, that they cannot even be considered as moral, no matter how much they may resemble moral qualities. For example, a dog can display affection or docility towards its master, but no one would consider it or describe it as moral or good-mannered. Similarly, a child or a mentally unstable individual may behave in a manner which has the appearance of moral action, but no sensible person would call such conduct moral, since it does not proceed from good sense or appropriateness, but is a manifestation or a natural reaction to circumstances or natural stimuli. His Holiness explains, a human infant, as soon as it is born, seeks its mother's breasts, and a chicken, as soon as it is hatched, begins to pick up corn. In the same way, the spawn of a leech behave like a leech. A baby serpent behaves like a serpent, and a tiger cub behaves like a tiger. A human infant begins to exhibit human reactions as soon as it is born, and those reactions become more and more remarkable as it begins to grow up. For instance, its weeping becomes louder, and its smiles become laughter, and its gaze becomes more concentrated. At the age of a year or 18 months, it develops another natural trait. It begins to display its pleasure and displeasure through its movements and tries to strike someone or to give something to someone. All these motions are natural impulses. Similar is the case of a savage or a barbarian. Its behavior is mainly based on natural impulses or a reaction to natural stimuli. It is possible that some reactions may resemble good morals, but they are normally not the result of reasonable reflection and consideration. And even if some were to be, overall, such a person is normally dominated by their natural conditions or their natural impulses. In short, the time for true morals begins when a person's reasoning matures to an extent that they're able to tell the difference between good and bad. They're able to distinguish between the two. And they feel sorry when they miss an opportunity to do good, and they feel remorseful when they end up doing bad. This is the stage which is described by the Holy Quran as the self that incites to evil. And His Holiness further explains this by stating, it should, however, be remembered that casual admonition is not enough to lead a barbarian to the stage of the self that reproves. It is necessary that he should become conscious of the existence of God to a degree at which he should not consider his creation as without purpose, so that an understanding of the divine should stimulate his true moral qualities. That is why God Almighty has drawn attention to the need of understanding of the divine, and has assured man that every act and moral produces an effect which brings about spiritual comfort or spiritual pain in this life, and will be manifested clearly in the hereafter. His Holiness then mentions an interesting point, that in the Arabic language, the word khalq denotes physical birth, whereas the word khulq, which is normally translated as morals, denotes inner birth. This is because inner birth is only perfected through moral development and not just through exercising natural impulses. His Holiness further explains, in short, all the natural qualities of man as courtesy, modesty, integrity, benevolence, jealousy, steadfastness, chastity, piety, equity, sympathy, bravery, generosity, forbearance, endurance, bountifulness, sincerity, loyalty, etc., when they are manifested on their proper occasions under the guidance of reason and reflection, would all be accounted moral qualities. In reality, they are the natural states and impulses of man and are designated moral qualities when they are exercised deliberately on their proper occasions. A natural characteristic of man is that he desires to make progress, and therefore, through following a true religion and keeping good company and conforming to good teachings, he converts his natural impulses into moral qualities. No other animal is invested with this characteristic. And that brings us to the end of today's video. In the next dars, we'll take a look at some of the commandments presented by the Holy Quran to reform our natural conditions, our natural selves. As mentioned before, I have linked the book in the description below. Please do make sure to subscribe, like, and share this video so that we can enable as many people as possible to benefit from the treasures left behind by the Promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam. Until next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.